This animal, aka the bear, came out today pretty severe. Just came out yesterday. It poked his little head out and woke up from hibernation, and then decided to eat a lot of profits. But without further ado, what we're going to be jumping into is going to be looking at some of the key stocks that a lot of people request about. We're going to talk about Lucid deal, which is, from the way I understand it, just super scummy and dilution of shares. And then at the same time, looking at the NASDAQ, looking at some price targets, and then looking at some predictions of where we could be seeing, where there could be some support on the lines, aka the charts. And I'm kind of just tearing that head off the bear here. But anywho, let's just gotta kind of get going here. We're going to be looking at Lucid, probably Tesla, SENS. A lot of people ask about that one. And then a couple little smorgasbord of other things. So let's go without further ado. If you haven't already, hit the like and subscribe button. I would greatly appreciate it. And at the same time, check out those affiliate links down below. The audiobooks are really helping me today. I'm trying to stay focused and not get too sidetracked with this craziness in the market. So let's go ahead and jump right in here to the NASDAQ, or we call it the NASDASTIES. It's just been nasty. Again, you can see the candles here, looking here at a daily chart here. We can kind of zoom in here on an hourly chart. You can see this basically waking up, getting alerted at 3 a.m, not able to sleep, and seeing this huge downfall. That an original Fibonacci number kind of came in for support, like we talked about, that we thought would be the initial like soft landing. That's not a soft landing, seeing the NASDAQ come down at these levels. And then kind of just peter around. Of course, we puke pretty hard come in the morning, and then now kind of been bouncing around. Most likely just going to be seeing chomp for the rest of the day, unless we get an update on stimulus bill, some kind of infrastructure bill or whatever. Like, I don't see any of these potentially running up the stock anytime soon. And just seeing kind of meander it into the close, limping, being beat down, getting like one ear's cut off, one of the eyeballs kind of falling out of the socket. But we're still able to walk. We still all have all our fingers and things like that. So I think that being said, if we do see some more selling coming today, because you have to think of it on like a psychology level, in the sense of, so yesterday it sold off into the close. So that normally, I don't know, statistically speaking, like 80% of the times could continue the selling the following day, because it has to hit everyone's, this information has to hit everyone's membrane, in the sense of hitting their noggin. So all the apes in the world have to get this information, and that takes time to distribute all that information of like, holy guacamole, why is the stock down today? Let me sell, panic sell, panic sell, panic sell, panic sell. And then at the same time, on my shoulder, I have the bull saying, hey, Ken, you should buy something. I'm like, I don't know, Mr. Bull, it's terrible out there. It hurts. Daft Punk retired and the market's crashing. And then Mr. Bull's like, Ken, you should buy something. Just add a little bit. You don't have to add full size. Just add a little bit. Add to your high conviction trades. I'm like, okay, Mr. Bull, let me go eat some lemon cake and let me think about it some more. And then I have a piece of lemon cake. The bull gives me good advice. And then I buy some of the stocks that I have high conviction trades in. So with this being said, so looking here on the NASDAQ, let's actually conform this into the QQQs. We're seeing that level that we talked about potentially around 315 to hold. If this does not hold, that's again below the 50-day, which is that little red line there. We could easily potentially see the selling if it does continue. Really looking for some potential chop for at least the rest of the week, because again, a market downpull like this does not happen this fast unless everyone gets all the information at the same time. This takes a little bit more time to kind of go through the flow. It takes a little bit of a wave to kind of starts crashing into all the other infrastructures of these people. Because again, I'm working on this video about analogies on using the ocean or the animal kingdom on how the stock market works. Stay tuned for that. I think you're going to really like it. So with that, looking for potentially the 89 EMA. I know if Ryan out there, high five, that 89 EMA has come down to a lot of the stocks we're about to look at. So the 89 EMA is the why you say 89, Ken, because I'm a 6 year old kid and I use the 89 EMA because I like fib numbers. So we could see that potentially with the NASDAQ if it does pull back and we get more selling coming into the rest of the week. If we get some bad news, whatever, we're going to be looking for 308 to 305 potentially. That's going to be around the 89 EMA. So let's go ahead and just jump to the old Tesla. Of course, Tesla really has been puking for the last couple of days, but it really just kind of rolled over today. Again, look at that blue line, that teal line. I'm actually having to change this color. So if you leave a nice, wonderful comment and say nice words about the video and actually give me a color on what color you would like to see the 89 EMA be highlighted as, you've got quite a range of different colors to pick from. So go ahead and have a ball with that, ladies and gentlemen, on that. So the 89 EMA, it's coming down to here. So that's basically around that 670-ish range. We talked about potentially 722 to hold, but that the selling dose was too strong. It broke right through that door and potentially could see this go down a little bit further. Again, 89 EMA is pretty strong. But again, staying with the NASDAQ, I don't have a crystal ball. I just have to listen to them, look at what the market does and react to what the market does. I can't predict. I wish I could tell it what to do so I can make trillions of dollars and then go play golf or just go fly airplanes all day. But that being said, we're looking for, if this does flush lower, we're going to be looking for around 600 to 583 to be the next level of support. But that's going to be if there's another pullback in the overall market, of course, or there's some bad news isolated towards Tesla. Another one that I've been getting a lot of questions about is that CCIV, those mother truckers over there. Very much, I think we're going to find out more and more. I think it was very much these SPACs are very little, what's the right word if I don't get in trouble? Let's just say scummy. I think that's a good word. It's just not very transparent in the sense of like dilution of the shares and this was pumped up pretty heavily here because, again, you can see that movement on the 5 and 8 moving averages coming down to that 21, kind of bouncing off that $31 price target. Again, technically speaking, the chart looked fantastic, but there was some kind of news that dropped this and gapped this lower. Yes, it has been confirmed. Yes, this thing was fairly much overhyped, but we'll see on how this continues and how this really plays out in the near term. But a lot of folks I know have gotten hurt. Again, a cut down at 30% after it was confirmed, and it was like, and then it was kind of dilution of the shares, and then now they're giving numbers that are 6 years out that they're going to be evaluating as much as these kind of companies, but they are still working on trying to get a car in production. Yes, they have a factory and they're doing things, but there hasn't been any like a ramping of getting these things up and running. So as you know, if you remember the Tesla story, logistically and the process of getting all those parts to come together is a pain in the butt. And we'll see on how Lucid does. Again, they're looking for this deal to close in Q2. And I think the ticker's gonna be like, ticker symbol's gonna be like LICD or something like that. I don't know, but we'll find out. We'll kind of keep this one on the list and kind of look at. But the one will be touching that one, the 10-foot pole. And then SENS, of course, this is also one that was very much heavily driven by momentum. Of course, gapping down fairly large today. Now it's kind of holding around that 350, which is again the 21 EMA. So being mindful of that, looking at that 21 to 34 EMA being potential buy zone. If you think this can continue this momentum and going higher, and then also looking for that we do have earnings on the 4th of March. So the 4th, that's 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 for all the languages out there. I only know those. Those are the languages that the levels are going to be looking at. So if that can hold around 350, maybe build a base here. Could come back down to 315 in the short term. Even down to $3 or $3.15 to $3 would be the short-term support. But the next level to try to break out, again, you're seeing that 5 and 8 moving averages really curled down here. If we break above $4, then again, really trying to get back up to that to break to that $6 range. But again, we have earnings coming out the 4th of March, so be mindful of that and be very careful out there. A couple other tickers that I'm thinking, I'm trying to think if anyone's been asking about. Of course, it was AMD, was a couple of them. AMD, this has definitely been a dog here with that gap down. Pretty strong looking candle here. But again, like we talked about in the live stream yesterday and on Sunday, this is a level where this is just not fun. It's not fun to hold some of the calls that I had. So I had to actually roll them out. And actually cut back on some of them due to the exponential cost that I'm getting here. I added a little bit to the stock here, but again, that $84 price target to $83 could be a level of support. We're bouncing off that 144 EMA there. Then at the same time, we can look at the old Apple. Apple, kind of the same candle, getting that very strong reversal candle here, coming down to that 144 EMA again. That 120 price target that we had initially for some strong support has been met. So we have to update that actually there. So we want to break that below here. Looking for this potentially to hold. If this doesn't hold and we break 120, say hello to 115 to 113, which is going to be kind of bouncing around the 200 EMA. So, and then also being collegiate, that's not a right word, being very transparent, maybe that's a better word. We have not broken past that 89 EMA in Apple for quite some time, ever since it split, or even way before the virus itself, okay? So Apple's pullback is pretty extensive here. So with this 5 and 8 moving averages really pointing down, would like to maybe try to build a base here. If it does get a chance to run up to like that 125 range and maybe start consolidating here and then get that next ramp up higher whenever that could come. So being very looking forth of that. A couple of things people have asked about is the old Bitcoin down 12% as we speak here, but it came down all the way to that 21 EMA at $44,000, which we've talked about being some support. Really had an alert here at $39,000 or $40,000 a piece to potentially add to it. The momentum is, again, shifting here. No one likes to really buy on this really fast falling red knife. I call it the hot steak knife or hot chef knife. Basically, it's a very fast moving stock that is just dropping down. And if you ever drop a very sharp knife, you don't want to catch it. You just want to put your hands up and step away, because if you try to catch it with the blade down, you're going to lose some fingers, or you're really going to cut and do some damage there. If it's a good chef knife, actually. If you're using those crappy chef knives, probably from, I don't know, insert shitty knife company here, in the sense of you could really hurt yourself there. A couple other things that a lot of other folks have talked about and asked about as well. I'm trying to look for some moves that have been going moving well. I just actually was asked about Snap again. Looks like some people are buying up on Snap. People are within the Discord. Again, if you're not interested, or if you have not already joined or not even interested, we have a Discord link down below. Again, I should update it. If I don't, I should update that though. So that is one thing. Also, Snap is kind of popping off here due to a lot of influx of volume coming through. That is a pretty interesting one without a doubt. A couple of the things that we want to look at, some stocks. I'm just checking a couple channels here. Oh, NNDM. People have asked about NNDM. NNDM, whew, that, guess what? That came down to that 89 EMA. I had that alert at 9.55. Still trying to recover here. Very large gap down. We're somewhat kind of filling this really hesitant, a lot of movement here. So we do a volume profile analysis on this. This came down right to that 1097-ish range where it's currently trading at. That's going to be a significant volume level that we could see potentially hold. If we do sell off, we're going to initially in the short term going to be looking for 950 to hold for NNDM. So without further ado, that's basically what we're going to be looking at again. Looking at the market on the S&P 500, we're not even closer to the 89 EMA because, again, most of this transition was out of heavy growth and the NASDAQ stock. So, yeah, with that cup of information there, please, if you haven't already, hit the like and subscribe down below, and I'll catch you guys on the flip side on the next video. Peace.